Good morning. Welcome back to SJ 336, St. John 336. This is Stephanie Jeanette, and we're on day 111. Scriptural references suggested for study are 1 John 5 and 4, Leviticus 26, 8, James 5, 16, that's 1-6, James 5, 16, 1 Thessalonians 3, 12, and 5, 11, Philippians 2 and 3, Exodus 18, the entire chapter with emphasis on verses 5 through 27. And I'm going to read 1 Thessalonians 3, 12 and 5, 11, and Philippians 2, 3. First in the King James Version. And the Lord make you to increase and abound in love, one toward another, and toward all men, even as we do toward you. Wherefore, comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even as also you do. Let nothing be done through strife or vainglory. Let nothing be done through strife or vainglory, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem other better than themselves. And for the English Standard Version, 1 Thessalonians 3:11. Wait, hold on. 3:12. And may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, as we do for you. Five 11. Therefore, encourage one another and build one another up, just as you are doing. Philippians 2 and 3. Do nothing from rivalry or conceit. Do nothing from rivalry or conceit, but in humility, count others more significant than yourself. And this suggested praise and worship song for this day 111. The Battle Is Not Yours by Yolanda Adams. This YouTube upload has a date of January 10th, 2009. The Battle Is Not Yours by Yolanda Adams. YouTube upload dated January 10th, 2009. Okay, and for the entry. Regarding the second concern on the list, housing, the minister in charge ought to pray and fast regularly for affordable and safe housing for the church's congregants and their loved ones, wherever they may be, perhaps traveling, etc. Also, she or he could arrange for educational forums and the maintenance of information and contacts regarding purchasing a home, purchasing land, renting the same, and leasing, being a landlord. Lessons regarding home insurance and being a landlord are also not beyond the scope of church activity, as we aim to advance the kingdom of Christ Almighty right here on earth as we wait for his return. Relevant to mention here is how every state has a first-time homebuyers program that helps through such vehicles as IDAs, call them IDAs, individual development accounts. The prospective buyer regularly saves up to a certain amount and receives an incentive toward the purchase of a home for the first time, which is defined as the very first time or after having not purchased or owned a home within 3 years. I would suggest that the church itself, each state may vary, so you would need to check on that. But generally speaking, they're called IDA programs, and different banks, sometimes community credit unions, but also banks will have like a particular agent who handles that kind of thing, or a banker, and they can establish the account, and you have to save a certain amount usually every month. And when you get to, like for instance, one state has it, when you get to 1,000, then they will tack on 4,000. So you basically will have your, and it's not a grant or anything, not a grant, and it's not a loan. It's just like a saving incentive. And, you know, that helps significantly towards your owning a home. I would suggest that the church itself act as such a vehicle, but it would require very mature members to participate and not have it become something perverse of the house of prayer. Also, under this line of missionary work within the local church, one would place the concerns of maintenance for the homes of elderly or otherwise disabled persons. I would suggest employing the help of the teenagers for this under close supervision, and that there'd be a regular addressing of these concerns, whether quarterly or semi-annually. As we pursue the addressing of all concerns prayerfully and dedicatedly, God Almighty will honor that work and work miracles on our behalf. Also, by having this level of engagement and committed concern, congregants feel and think with connection as opposed to isolation. Not to form a cult or anything, but to encourage, not to form a cult or anything, but to encourage actions born out of accountability and community versus independence, codependence, and self-centeredness. All that we do does have an effect on others, and it behooves us to make a bigger impact as salt and light unto a continuously more wretched world by unitedly applying our faith to our daily needs, that God Almighty would glorify himself on our behalf and his addressing the concerns likewise. In the intercessory prayer, dear Father God Almighty, we pray for the families of today, Lord, that they may worship and honor you together. Help one another to recognize and develop their God-given talent, and by your supernatural spirit, make the connections to get their impact felt by more and more of those who still need to hear of you. And Lord, may Comoros, Comoros, be blessed by the overpowering renewal by the Holy Ghost, and turn the hearts of the people there to your dear and only begotten Son, Christ Jesus. In Christ Jesus' holy and precious name we do pray. Amen. Thank you so much for tuning in to SJ336. This has been day 111. Have an excellent day.